ordained a priest. Please come forward.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain this man, our brother, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose thee, our brother, for the order of the priesthood.
Thanks be to God.
Of the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered through your hands in an unbloody manner on the altar, in union with the sacred assembly, in the celebration of the divine liturgy. Understand what you do. Imitate what you celebrate. As a minister of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, strive to put to death whatever in your life is sinful and walk always in the newness of life. Remember, when you gather others into the people of God through baptism, when you forgive sins in the name of Christ and his church in the sacrament of penance, when you comfort and heal the sick with holy oil, when you celebrate sacred rites, when you offer prayers of praise, thanks, and intercession through the liturgy of the hours for the church and for the whole world, remember that you are taken from among men and appointed on their behalf for all those things that pertain to God. Therefore, carry out the ministry of Christ the priest with constant joy, genuine love, attending not to your own concerns, but to those of the Lord and those that you serve. Remember as well, my dear son, exercising for your part the office of Christ the head and chief shepherd, while always united with the bishop and subject to him, work to bring the faithful together into one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father through his Son Jesus Christ and in the power of the Holy Spirit. Throughout the coming years of your priesthood, strive to imitate the missionary zeal of Père Marquette, the heroic witness of Gabriel de la Borde, the proto-martyr of Illinois, the generosity of John Marie Vianney, the patron saint of all parish priests, the determined energy of John Lancaster Spalding, our founding bishop, the manifest holiness of Venerable Fulton Sheen, and the good example of the many priest heroes who came before you and labored so hard to build up the Holy Church of Peoria. As a priest, consciously honor in your ministry the heavenly patrons of this diocese, the prayerfulness of St. Therese of Lisieux, the quiet strength of St. Joseph the Worker, and the incomparable sanctity of our Blessed Lady, St. Mary of the Immaculate Conception. Remember always, Christ is our High Priest, our temple, our sacrifice, the incarnation of God's Word. If you wish to heal wounds, he is the doctor. If you wish to deliver from sin, he is our justification. If you long to flee from darkness, he is the light. If you hunger for food, he is nourishment. If you fear death, he is life everlasting. If you wish to see God face to face, he is the way. And in his great goodness, the Lord Jesus Christ accomplishes this wonderful work of salvation in the form of a servant. So you must always seek God's will and not your own. In holy orders, you will be ordained not for your own convenience, but for ministry. Therefore, keep always before your eyes the example of Christ, the Good Shepherd, who came not to be served, but to serve, and to seek out and save all those who were lost.